Good day, children. Today we are going to study Standard 10th Poem 2.4 The Pulley by George Herbert, 1593 to 1633. Now, what is pulley? Pulley means to attract. It has an attraction or a power, we can say. Pulley is a mechanical device. It's a poem also. It's a metaphysical poem which speaks about devotion, nature and science. It is a religious poem, as George Herbert mostly wrote religious poem. So the poem Pulley tells us to attract the things which we want closer to us. It is also a mechanical device to attract certain objects nearer or closer to us in a scientific language. But if we speak about spirituality, pulley is a device or a power which attracts human being closer to God. George Herbert was a Welsh poet. He was from Wales. He was a priest. He was a good orator, a poet, and a priest in the Church of England. His poetry is associated with the writing of the metaphysical poets, and he is recognized as one of the foremost British devotional lyricists. He was born into an artistic and a wealthy family and largely raised in England. He received a good education that led him to the admission of Trinity College. He went there in the intention of becoming a priest, but he became the university public orator. Orator means speaker, and attracted the attention of kings. He also served in the Parliament of England. He mostly wrote a religious poem and spoke about religion, about a Christian era. Now, in this poem, we are going to first see warming up exercise on page number 69. You can see you have certain images and words written it. You have to match the image with the words. Each and every words given to you all on this page give some motivational or inspirational thought to our living life. If see the summary of the poem, The Pulley is written by George Herbert, who speaks on one part of the Christian creation of Christian era. It's a biblical poem written on a Bible scripts. The Christian creation story, in which God chose to be imbibed in humanity with blessings. The poem begins with a speaker stating that he is retelling the story, means he's telling the story about the creation, that how world was created and how God created the world. He is particularly interested in the part where God gives humankind knowledge, wisdom, beauty and strength. These are the important features of human existence that flowed easily from God to humankind. Means God has given us all the gifts which are there in the world freely. There is one blessing that God did not let out of his cup, means he did not give to the people. Only one blessing God has kept with him. He chose to withhold an innate ability to rest from humankind in order to keep his creation close to him. He gave all the powers, he gave all the things to the people, but one thing he has kept with him, that is rest, which he has not given to the creator. When one gets very means frustrated or they are disturbed, when they have a failure, they turn to God. Or that is his reasoning. Herbert Speaker states that God did not want humanity to love nature more than they love the God of nature. Means God is also selfish over here. That God doesn't want that his creation should love anything else more than him. So he has kept one power in his hand, that is a power of rest. That when person wants to rest, means not to sleep, when the person is tired of what will the world luxurious thing, and the person says that now enough, I want to rest, I want peace, and then he goes in searching of God. Now you have the poem in 9th standard, the Tansen. In that Tansen poem, you have seen same thing, when the king goes for rest, searching of God. So here you have an image where you see God is standing with the hands raised. He is waiting for the people to come and visit him, means to come and rest wherever they want to rest at God. Now in this poem, the first stanza speaks that when God at first made man, having a glass of blessings standing by, let us, said he, pour on him all we can. Let the world's riches which despised lie contract into span. The first stanza tells us that God has given us all the blessings in the cup, filled with blessings. But at the end of the cup, at the bottom of the cup, he has kept one thing left, and that is rest, that he has not given to the people. He gave all the world richness, and that richness are scattered here and there. God has a power to collect everything in one place, means contract into a span. He can collect it everything in one place, and he can give to the people in their hand when they are coming to God, means when they are coming to rest. The second stanza says that so strength first made a way, then beauty flowed, then wisdom, honor, pleasure. When almost all was out, God made a stay, perceiving that alone of all his creatures, rest in the bottom lay. Means here I have shown you the image. The image see at first shows the power of God. The power of God, God is holding all the things in his hand, and then after giving everything to the people, when people are satisfied at the end, when they want to rest, so God is giving him the hand and he is pulling the person, means it's like a pulley. The second stanza says that God has the power to give humanity strength, wisdom, honor, and pleasure. But only he has kept one treasure with him, and that is a treasure of rest, which he has not given to the people. He wants the people to come closer to him to take that treasure of rest. Here you can see strength is given by God, humankind, knowledge is also given, and patience is also given. Wisdom is also given. God has given everything to us. Nothing he has kept with him, but only one power he has kept with him, and that is rest. Now in this para, The writer says, "For if I should," said he, "bestow this jewel," this jewel means the jewel of rest, "also on my creature," means who he has created, "he will adore my gifts instead of me." He will not worship me. He will worship all the gifts which I have given to him. "And rest in nature, not the god of nature. So both should loser be." So here God says that if I give the gift of rest also to man, then man will love the nature. He will not love me. I am the creator of nature, so he should love me, because God is also selfish. God is telling that love me first, because I have created the world, so you should love me. How our parents demand to us, na? Ki the parents always want, mommy and daddy, they want that our child should love us. My child should respect me. My child should listen to me. My child should come early in the house at night. He should not waste time outside. So same way, the God is also lover of his creature. The last paragraph tells us, "Yet let him keep the rest, but keep them with ripening restlessness. Let him be rich and weary. Then at last, if goodness lead him not, yet weariness may toss him to my breast." Here God says that let the person enjoy everything. I am giving him the power of rest also, but he will only sleep, but he will be restless, means he will not get a proper sleep because of his continuous anxiety, dissatisfaction which he has in his life, greed of money, greed of wealth, greed of education, greed of comparison, greed of competition, which will keep him always restless. And at last, he will be tired of everything, richness, education, wealth, everything he will be tired. And after being tired, he will think of me, he will think of God, and then he will come to my breast, and he will try to find rest under my guidance. So your God is a creator, but he is also a selfish person, where he wants that the person who he has created, the things which he has created, should at last come to me for the rest. So here the poet tells us the nature of God, which appears entirely selfish. Though it is not clear in the poem, he has not said that God is selfish, but the words, the comparison which he has made, tells us that God is also selfish. Because you all also, when you all want to pass, you all study full year, you all waste time full year, but when we want to pass, at the end we go to God and then we start praying to God. So the writer tells us about the weariness which helps humanity aside from forcing them to come closer to God. Means it is pulling the person closer to God. So here we end up with the poem, "The Pulley," means to pull closer to God. Here in this moving image, you can see it is a simple device, but it gives us a strong message that nothing is in the hands of human being. Though God has given us all the powers to achieve materialistic things on the earth, but still he holds the power and our strings in the form of pulley and kept us restless. Here we finish up with the explanation of the poem. You are instructed to write the poem in your English notebook and complete the given English workshop in the poem. Thank you.